So this is my 3,500 points of Imperial Guard. So you'll see it's very tank heavy in this themed game against the geeks. So we'll start with the combined arms attachment. So at the front here we have got a command tank here, tank commander with a las cannon and a hunter killer. He's in his squadron, he's got two more Lehman Russes, both with las cannons, but this one's got a hunter killer and this one's got heavy stubber. In the heavy choice we have got this exterminator with a heavy stubber, multi-melters and a las cannon. Here we have a standard Lehman Russ with a las cannon and heavy stubber. We've got a Punisher over here with a heavy bolter. In the fast choice, moving over here, we've got a Hellhound squadron with a standard Hellhound and a Devil Dog there with a multi-melter in the hull. We've got a Salamander scout vehicle. We've got three troop choice, each of which is armed pretty much identically actually, and in Chimeras with heavy bolters and heavy stubbers. So the veteran squads are armed with two melter guns, a plasma gun and a missile launcher, which is very nice. And the Lord of War for the combined arms detachment is this Shadow Sword with two las cannons and heavy bolter sponsons. And moving over here, we've got a Steel Host detachment. So this comprises of a tank commander, three separate Lehman Russ squadrons and the Hydra. So for the tank commander here, we've got a Vanquisher with a las cannon and a hunter killer. We've got a Executioner with two plasma sponsons and a las cannon. We've got a Lehman Russ squadron of exterminators here with heavy bolter sponsons, heavy bolter hull mounted, and of course the auto cannons on top. We have got a Demolisher there with a heavy bolter and a hunter killer. We've got a standard Demolisher there, no upgrades at all. And we've got a Hydra flak tank. And that is my 3,500 points of guard. And it's looking really impressive laying this all out. It's gonna be an absolutely brutal game. If you love tanks, this is a battle report of the year for you guys. So let's go over and have a look to see what John is bringing today.
Okay guys, so here we go with the 3.5k from the geek side. I've got a platoon command squad with a Chimera. We agreed on a bit of a house rule that everybody needs to be mechanized. So his platoon is also mechanized. We've got one, two, three squads that all have a Chimera. They all have... Tell you what, sorry guys, I'm going to start that again. So I always get Chimera and it's a Chimera. Okay guys, so here we go with the 3.5k from the geek side, and we're going to start with a platoon command squad mounted in a Chimera. We agreed on a bit of a house rule that everything was going to be mechanized, so we've got one, two, three squads all mounted in Chimeras. They've all got a melt gun embedded in there. We've got a priest embedded in one and a commissar embedded in the other squad. And then let's go have a look at what we all came here for, which is really all about the tanks. So my warlord is in a Vanquisher, and he's got another Vanquisher as a wingman. Then we've got a squad with a regular Lehman Russ and an Annihilator. We've got another squad with a Lehman Russ and an Annihilator there. We've got the Bane Blade. We've got Malkador Infernus. Got another squad of Lehman Russ in the center there, a Demolisher, regular Lehman Russ, and the variant with the auto cannons. And then in the air, we've got the Avenger Strike Fighter with las cannons, and we've got the Vendetta, which is going to have a lot of targets there for its las cannons. So, oh guys, I'm so excited to see how this pans out. I have no idea what's going to happen during this battle, but I can guarantee one thing, it sure is going to be a lot of fun.
This is Tom from Blacktoad Studio, and I'm joined obviously by Dom, and also we have John from Geeks Wargame. Sorry, don't get your face in there. And we are here to play through a Treadhead's Dream battle. We have 3,500 points aside of basically tanks, tanks, tanks. And obviously you've seen the army list, but this is the deployment. I'll just go and do some shots around here so you can have a look at where everything on the field is. The scenario we've gone for is big guns never tire, because we thought it was quite fitting for this particular battlefield and battle. So we've got four objectives in total. And as I just pan past John's deployment here, you can see that there's one in his deployment area, and we have two in the middle. And as we move back into Dom's deployment area over here, see this epic tank army over here, another objective in the middle down there. So the scenario rules dictate that all the objectives are worth 3 points each, and each heavy support blown up is an additional 1 point each. So this should be quite interesting by the time we get to the end of the game, if there's actually anything left on the table. So without further ado, we'll move on to the first turn, which is currently Dom's, unless John would like to seize, which I think he does. No seize. So we'll move on to Dom's tanks, turn one. So as we move into turn one for Dom's tanks, which I'm going to affectionately call them, as you hear, needs to move forward. And pretty much the same across the line. You'll see a little bit of movement here as most tanks just move on up the battlefield towards their chosen targets, which I'm sure we'll find out about very soon in the shooting phase. So that is turn one movement. We'll now move on to the shooting phase. So as we enter turn one shooting phase for Dom's tanks, we'll start on this side of the board with a couple of very swift movements up here. So they've gone flat out to try and get nearer their quarry over here, taking a gamble that they don't get shot. Same with the salamander. And I've moved to this side of the board and see the results of the old shooting. So over here we have a baneblade which has gone down to 3. And also over here we had a couple of shots coming here, but nothing much has actually happened. Over here the Macador's taken quite a few hull points off, they're left with 1. And then as we move on around here, I'll show you some of the other orders that have gone off. So order-wise, we've got some smokes popped on this squadron here. Got some more smokes popped on the Punisher down here. And we have smokes popped here, and here. And did the Hydra move back a bit, I think, at some point. So that's everything that's happened in the shooting phase. So nothing actually blown up, unfortunately. But we'll soon change that, I have a suspicion. We'll now move on into John's tanks, turn one. So here we go with John's turn one movement, and a little bit of movement down here. So the Baneblades shuffle forward along with these two Russes. The immobilized Chimera here has deposited its guardsmen there, so heading towards what they need to go for over here. Other than that, these have all moved forward here as well. The Malkador's gone up. These guys are all sat here waiting to shoot. So we'll now move on to turn one shooting and see what happens. So as we head into turn one shooting for John from Geeks, a lot of fires came into Dom's opposing tank force. So we'll sort of walk around here and I'll guide you through some of the results that cropped up. So obviously the Vanquished over here fired into a couple of the squadrons here and a couple of the individual tanks, and a few hull points have been ticked off. So obviously a couple of tanks and 2 hull points there. And here the Chimeras have taken quite a lot of firepower into them. However, they've somehow managed to weather it. I think some smokes cover saves helped save, and also some hold down from this shooting over here. The Baneblade has fired in, hit quite a few tanks over here, including a wall-mounted Chimera now. But a couple of hull points have been chipped off in here. Not too much damage, quite surprising really. It's been quite interesting shooting phases for both sides. Mainly small things getting popped here and there. So obviously this Guardsman squad's been shot out of their Chimera. And then finally over here, we've got these two Hellhounds here have not really taken too much damage from the two opposing tanks sitting in the ruins over there. So one just sitting on 2 hull points. So that is everything from this turn one. We'll now move on to turn two for Dom. So here we go with turn two for Dom's tanks, so army, and we have hit the movement phase here. So these two, Devil Dog and Hellhound, have moved up towards their current target over here. So hopefully there might be another thing going to pop there. The Salamander very bravely pushing forward, hoping to be ignored by everything, getting some rear armor shots at some point. And then as we move over to this side of the battlefield, had a little bit of movement over here, which could So obviously Demolisher taking the lead there, trying to get a shot because obviously it's short barrel range. And then as we move into the middle here, a little bit more movement here as the two Chimeras that have been hit up a little bit have ploughed forward. So obviously they've got some weapons inside that can probably do some damage. And over here another couple of tanks move forward here. And over here the Hydra has repositioned itself again in preparation for a potential airstrike coming in from reserves. So that's the movement phase. We'll now move on into the shooting phase and see what Astra blows up. So as we hit turn two for Dom in the shooting phase, over here, some super heavy melter shots from the Devil Dog plowed into one of these rusters here and managed to take it out. We move across the table here, we had some more hull points chipped off here. And again over here, move around here, another one back down here on this Chimera. Then things really started to heat up as the Malkador Infernus decided to go boom. As you see, a nice big gap here. Now the Apocalypse Blast then scattered left, and unfortunately a D hit the squad of men right in between all this lot here, and managed to also chip off a hull point off this Chimera. Back here, this Chimera was destroyed as well, and the men jumped out the back for safety. And that is pretty much all the shooting that was achieved in this turn. However, stuff is now starting to leave the board. So we'll now move on to John's turn two and see what happens in his movement and shooting. So as we plow into turn two movement for John from Geeks, there is a couple of new arrivals on the board. So we've got a Vendetta and another flyer over here that is flown on from reserve. Obviously they've taken a nice short range move on to make sure that they've got a lot of shooting potential in the future turns. So, other than that, we have a bit of movement from these guardsmen. These two poor guardsmen have fallen back because they just couldn't stand the sight of all their friends burning in front of them. We've got some more movement here from the Russians moving forward up here, along with the Baneblade as well. And other than that, I think everything else has stayed put for the time being. So, we'll now move into the shooting phase in turn two and see what happens. So as we roll on to turn two shooting for John from Geeks Wargaming, this has really been a turn where the hurt has been turned onto this side of the board. So down here, the Baneblade doing the majority of the damage down here with its large cannon and demolisher cannon flying in here and taking off various hull points and destroying two at the front here. So not good times in this particular area. And over here we've got demolisher rounds coming in, plasma, and we get a Chimera downed, and the squad inside has retreated backwards, not liking their odds at the moment. This squad here had a miraculous survival rate from the battle cannon over there, and various heavy bolts and laser cannon shots came in snap firing, obviously, and didn't actually manage to kill any of them in the end because of some miraculous cover saves. Over here, another set of chipping of hull points over here, and from these came in from the Vanquishers and the other one, the laser destroyer here, and also the flyers all shot over in this area here and chipped off various hull points. So with that being the end of turn two, quite destructive there, we'll now see what happens in turn three for Dom and as I'm in, see if he can pull back a few tank chassis in his favour. So as Dom moves into turn three for movement, over here the Devil Dog and the Salamander have both parked back to back for a bit of protection and also to put a bit of threat here, and also the rear armour with the autocannon on the Baneblade. And as you can see here, tanks have started to move over the crest of the hill or ramparts there and make their way towards various targets along with the infantry. Likewise over here, the two squads, this one rallying this turn, has moved forward to get their metal guns and various other anti-tank weaponry in range and actually get some use out of them. So finally over here, the plasma-based Russ has moved forward, and along with all these other Russes and the Punisher, obviously kind of get into range to actually do some damage. So that's the move for this phase. We'll now move on into the shooting phase. So turn three for Dom here in the shooting phase, and A lot of shots have been flying around. Not successful in places, not so in the other places. Over here, got a lot of the weaponry over here, far over at the two vanquishers who are hull down over here, and managed to take off two hull points. Only glances though, so nothing spectacular. Some wild shots were fired up at the flyer here. No jink was issued, and it survived, didn't even get hit. Moving a little bit further over here, we had quite a lot of fire coming over here, and the Baneblade has bit the dust, although it did take quite a few shots from various locations over here before it did fall. It did go, obviously exploded, it scattered back a little bit, but actually, fortunately, the template where it landed did not inflict any casualties on any of the vehicles over here. So that is all of the shooting for this phase. We'll now move on to turn three for John and see how things go. So over here, the Vendetta jinked from the incoming fire from the Hydra. However, sadly, the Hydra all the way over there decided that it wasn't good enough to take it out. So although it has jinked, so it is snap firing. And over here, the Devil Dog, despite its proximity to the exterminator over here, did not manage to do anything to it. It failed to penetrate with its 2d6. So that's the end of turn three. We're now for Dom anyway, and I'll move on to turn three for John and see what happens. So as we hit turn three for John, over here we can see that it's a pretty much a let's get forwards kind of turn. So down here the Chimeras have all split off and started moving in different directions just to try and get to where they're needed. So this one moving off towards this little skirmish in the corner over here. But it's only backing off a bit just to try and make sure it's not got on the rear armour. The Vendetta has moved forward as well. Down over here, because troops have again moved up. However, in this corner, stuff staying pretty static, feeling quite safe, hulled down in this area down here. The Flyer has moved forward to get into some firing range with some of its weaponry. So, that's the movement phase. Now we'll head on into the shooting phase and see what's going on. So turn three for John here and his shooting phase. Over here we had some autocannon shots firing to Devil Dog here and take a hull point off. The Salamander somehow defies all the shots being fired at it and actually survives. The Vendetta here and this Russ here both shot over in this area and managed to take out the leading tank there. However, it was the Vendetta that did the damage even though it was snap firing, so he managed to get his shots off and actually hit. We had a demolisher around here. Fire over here and didn't actually do anything because it didn't actually manage to penetrate, so it was over here rather. And over here, the Avenger was about to do a strafe on troops but decided to take a pot shot with its las cannons at the executioner at the front there. Actually, it was the exterminator, I do apologise. And managed to actually take it out with some very, very good penning and a six on the explosion shot. So that's pretty good. Lastly, in this corner, all these tanks are firing over and managed to strip one hull point off the lead demolisher here. So, lots of, I think, two more tanks go up in smoke. So that is the end of turn three for John, and we'll now move on to turn four for Dom. So here we go for turn four for Dom, and down here we had one of the demolishers moved forward here. The other one is obviously immobilised. This Russ has moved up rather. Moving over to this central location over here. We've had a pretty much across the board rollout towards objectives. That's because that is the score. They were 3 points each. So they've also got the Punisher moved up. That squad's moved up. Camaros, that's the exploded one, pardon me. The squad that was in it has moved forward. Only a 2-inch move though, so not too much progress. This squad over got much better and moved the full six and is getting forward quite nicely. And again, over in this corner, we've had a couple of shuffle arounds. The Devil Dog trying to reposition to try and get some side armour on this or us here. And over here, the Salamander has recomposed itself and said, yep, we need that objective, and moved itself back out to the centre. So, that is the movement phase. We'll now move on to the shooting phase and see what happens. So as we roll on to turn four for Dom, and we'll start on this side with the non-eventful stuff. So a lot of the weaponry from this squadron of tanks here all shot over the vanquishers, including the Shadow Sword, And a lot of misses, and also the Shadow Swords did actually hit, however, rolled a 1 on the table, so it was near miss for them. The Avenger unfortunately met its untimely end to a snap-firing missile launcher and the exterminator at the back over there, which pulled the crash down. However, that sergeant there is particularly nervous from where it actually landed. Moving on into the centre here. This demolisher met its end from this melter gun here, getting good sixes on there to get the penetration it needed. And over here we have the Vendetta sitting on one hull point now after doing some extreme no-jinking, obviously wanting to fire all its LAS cannons next turn. They came from various locations, including the Hydra over there, and the Salamander here shot at the Chimera, taking off one more hull point. Then moving on over here, the Devil Dog trying his luck again, a little bit luckier this time, managing to hit with his main cannon and take another hull point off here and shake and stun. So that is the end of turn 4 for Dom. We'll now move on to turn 4 for Dom. So as we go into the Geeks turn 4 for John here, this has been quite a bit of a battle, and we've got a lot of movement happening now because objectives are starting to come into play towards the end game. So here we've got a Chimera's set up on this one to try and hold it. This Chimera has moved forward to try and possibly push the Salamander off there so he can grab that one or at least deny it. And over here we've got these troops that have moved forward. Vendetta has powered on forward to try and get a few more shooting solutions on the remaining tanks at the back over there. Moving on over here, this corner again has stayed static, preferring its cover to try and take out this remaining tank horde in this corner over here, which has remained pretty chipped up but not actually destroyed. So yeah, as this is the movement phase turn 4, we're only going to 5 turns. So we're going to see what happens in this round and then moving on to the final in 5. So at the end of turn 4 for John, over here, the Vanquishers had a pretty good shooting day, taking out 2 demolishers over here. Not leaving much on this side of the table apart from the 3 chassis here. Also over here we had a few other shots flying from over here, didn't do much at all unfortunately. Moving on to the middle here, we had a lot of fire from various units here, firing from here and here into the troops over here, and it's fallen back, and also over here as well. And we had some fire here from the Chimera flying to the Salamander, didn't manage to do anything there, and also over here the snap shooting. So they managed to fire in but not do any damage. So that is the shooting phase for turn 4 there. We'll now move on to turn 5 for Dom and see if we can clean up some objectives. So as we embark on turn 5 for Dom's army over here, the Hydra over there has moved out to try and get a clipping shot on the tail of the Vendetta. Moving over here, the Devil Dog has been rather brave, position itself for the side armor shot here, trying to get out there. It did not immobilize itself while moving, which is good. Salamander has tried to consolidate its position on the objective, hopefully not getting itself destroyed. And moving over here, so these are moved forward as well into this position here to secure the objective as well. We had a little rally over here from these men that were running away and decided to come back into the fight. And then finally, just at the back here, is moved over to secure the objective at the end of the game here in turn 5. So we'll now move on to the shooting phase and see if they can pop a few more hulls up and see what happens. So as we roll into turn 5 shooting here, this is all fired down in this direction here. However, the Vanquisher's being very resilient still and not taking any hull points again. The Shadow Sword fired over here and managed to take off the hull points needed to get rid of the Annihilator. The LAS cannons fired from that also taking out of Chimera here and getting the men out. Over here, the Punisher also helped with that particular shooting phase, so getting rid of that. Over here, the Lucky Vendetta, quite a few shots fired up, snapshots from LAS cannons and also the Hydra over here. But has only managed to lose one hull point after opting not to jink. Moving on to this side of the table at the back over here. We have the Salamander, the Devil Dog over here, managed to finally take out his target in the last turn. So that's another point there. Finally in the middle here, the Salamander here took some more shots at this Chimera here, but unfortunately didn't manage to do anything. Oh, and as a slightly funny note, the plasma gun from this squad fired over here and unfortunately melted himself instead of doing any damage to it whatsoever. So that's the end of the, turn five for Dom. We'll now move into the final turn for John from Geeks and see how he gets on. So as we embark on turn five, the final turn for John here, he has moved up his Chimera to try and get hold of this objective here. Obviously being objective secured, there's a good chance of that. Over here, the Vendetta is elected to stay still for the moment because there's a couple of choice targets over there for denial and also for getting a Warlord kill, so little choice to make in the shooting phase shortly. Moving back over here again, this is all pretty much stay still because I think he's relying on the shooting of these guns to give him a little bit of an edge. And a lot of running and movement here over the wrecked tank to get these guys close enough to score the objective, and also over here these guys on their run move as well to try and get close, but they actually failed to get too close, so they are stuck there now with no shooting options. So that is all of the movement. It's been very interesting to see how the shooting phase pans out to see what happens. So let's go on to the shooting phase. So as the shooting phase wraps up, this final turn for John here, a lot of shots came in. There were some pretty abysmal actual penetration rolls. He almost cleared this one out here, except for some like a double one rolling. That was from the Vanquishers, and the tank over here only managed to take out the Executioner. Moving over here, obviously these guards from here fired the Melter into here, however managing not to do anything again. Which is a bit of a shame, but unfortunately for Dom that is an objective secured unit, so that is actually wrapped up another 3 points there. A couple of shots came in from here over to the guardsman down here. However, the big one over here, which is the Vendetta's choice, he did decide to go for the rearmost tank back here and actually managed to hit twice, but only didn't actually do any penetration on it whatsoever, so that is still held on this side of the table. So I think we're looking at quite a tight game here at the moment. We're going to have a little add up and see what's been going on, and we'll be back with the scores. So at the end of that epic battle there, we have gone through all the scores and added up various things here. So obviously just as the little quick add up of the main objective, so we've got the three here for John, so that gave him quite a solid 9 to start off with, and only 3 at the back there. However, when you add up all the heavy scores, it works out as John from Geeks Wargaming has 13 points, and Dom from our very own Blacktoad Studio has 10 points. So essentially, we had I think it was a really good game. I've been spectating this all the way through while filming it. It's been a lot of fun to watch, quite a few laughs here and there, as usual. But in the end, it turned out to be a really close game. So I hope all of you have watched, and obviously make sure if you enjoyed this game to check out some of our other battle reports on our channel, Battle of the Shield, but also, more importantly, also go and check out Geeks Wargaming's channels to see what they've got.
Okay, what a game. Well, for me, I think unit of the game had to be the Vendetta. Again, flying around, twin glass cannons all over the place, just taking out tanks. It's always good. Could have been very different if it taken out that heavy support tank right at the end there. Would have increased the margin of victory, but turns out I didn't need it anyway. Certainly a great unit. The Bane Blade was also very effective as well. Interesting to see how ineffective battle cannons are against other tanks. Yeah, a little bit unfortunate, but that is the army that I've got, and of course if it was against troops it'd be a really different story. But yeah, it was a good game, great opponent. I hope you enjoyed that bat rep as much as I enjoyed playing in it, and thanks for coming on the road trip with me, of course. And obviously if you like what you see, then please hit subscribe, and we look forward to seeing you on the next bat rep here at Geeks Wargaming. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, so great game against John from Geeks. Really quite surprising how poorly the Russ did
impenetrating a standard tank. It was basically bouncing off the armour. I feel it kind of went a little bit in John's favour when he had the Vanquishers obviously had the range over my Demolishers. My Demolishers got popped before they could even get towards the Vanquishers, and the Vanquishers being in cover were able just to pick off some of the Russians. But I feel he was able just to jump on the objectives at the end because they had more mechanised troops. And his troops have been able to keep in Chimeras, where my Chimeras have been popped relatively early and the troops have kind of diminished or stranded. So yeah, except for that, a couple of, you know, points I've learned from, but a really fun game. Really enjoyed it, especially being like a tank commander, a bit of a treadhead. I love having a tank games, and that was definitely on my list of things to do. So yeah, really fun game, really enjoyed it. I hope John's felt the same. So, yeah, good stuff.